Know decorate this year. Doing it after worship on the 27th. Thank you.
Tomorrow night, consistory meeting, 7 o'clock in the church office.
Are there any other announcements? Decorating is November 26th, not 27th, after church.
My announcement is, good morning, everybody. We're here to worship our Lord this morning, and that is really important, and not only important. We're going to leave here with a little more joy in our hearts. That's my expectation this morning, because we have gathered together. I want to mention just a couple of things. This afternoon at 3 o'clock, our denomination, the Penn Southeast Conference, will have their fall meeting, not here, but in the UCC Church in Amityville, and I will be going, and we have a couple of delegates for the meeting. Some will be on Zoom. I'm going there in person. If anybody would like to come along for the ride and just to experience that, I would be happy to go with. Have a couple of things. Wednesday, 2 o'clock, we have our weekly Bible study, Matthew chapter 19. Looking forward to it. And you're invited to come if you can make it. And finally, next Sunday, the Sunday before Thanksgiving, coming up, 4 o'clock in the afternoon at St. Paul's Lutheran Church in town here. We will have our community Thanksgiving service. That's next Sunday at 4 in the afternoon. And we'd love to see you there. That is all I have.
Let us prepare our hearts and minds for worship.
Thank you. so good to have Linda here today. And I had the real pleasure of working with her son in the gifted program, Kyle. So good to have you here today. My joy is looking at the bake sale table. Remember, there are no calories, none sold today, and all of those goodies are freshly baked, so buy them and put them in your freezer and enjoy them while you can during the holidays.
Yeah, we just don't eat them today.
Good morning. So it's Stewardship Sunday again this morning, and I just want to share that two Sundays ago, Bill Miller spoke, and Brenda and I were both moved to increase our giving. And Mark Mockimer spoke last week, and we were moved again. And thank God we are teaching Sunday school this morning. I really want to thank you, Mark, for your message. Thank you, Bill Miller, for your message as well. And I'm looking forward to seeing, I think, Judy Miller's giving it today. It's incredible the amount of money it takes to run this church, and I encourage everybody to listen to them. And when we're done giving, there's other ways we can give, right, with our treasures and our talent as well, so and our time. So thank you all.
Thank you. Another joy that we had.
My joy is that I said to my choir earlier in the season, and I said, you guys got to come to my church that I've been at for almost 17 years in November. I've been here, and I just love it here, and I just wanted to say that you guys are so welcoming. They loved it. They enjoyed singing here, and I'm sure they'll come back.
Chocolate, right? It's chocolate. Beautiful. Chocolate.
And I'm going to share it with you. The seven of us are going to eat some chocolate. Sorry, Sunday school teachers. It's part of the message, so okay. Now, I said a prayer, so it's got to work out. My message today, by the way, is about sharing. Share it what you have. I'm going to share chocolate with you. Are we ready? I hope it's okay. Hold your hands like this so you can receive the chocolate. All right? Okay. Okay. Oops, I got the wrong side. No, that is the right side. Oh, you're welcome. By the way, I didn't give you enough. There you go. All right. Okay. Now, somebody's allergic to chocolate. Please say something. I don't think too many people are. Okay. I feel good. Because I share something with you. Ah, I love it. This is my piece. Now, the message today is about sharing one with another. Sharing what you have with others brings joy to your heart. It makes you happy. Like I'm happy because I gave you chocolate. The Apostle Paul, so in our reading this morning, it's about giving. It's about giving. And he's asking the members of a church if they would give extra for another church that they can help. And so I hope that you will share with others. Do you share? Do you share your toys? Do you share stuff? Do you share anything with? Oh, I got to look at from your eye like maybe. Once in a while. Oh, there's not much in life better than to learn what it means to share. And the whole thing is, I just gave you a little dribble of chocolate, and I'm saying the whole thing for me. That is not what you're supposed to do, and you know it, don't you? You know it. I don't want to overdo it with the chocolate. In fact, I would probably be going to the hospital if I ate all this anyway. So, share. Give a little bit, okay? Wherever you have a chance. And you make somebody happy, you make you happy too. Let's have a prayer. Dear God, we bless these kids. We bless all of us. And when an opportunity comes to share something, to give, to make a difference that way. Help us say yes, do it. Amen. Thank you. You may be on your way. You thought I'd give you more, maybe. All right. And our scripture reading this morning will be from Caitlin Love.
First scripture reading is from Proverbs 3, verses 1 through 12. My child, do not forget my teaching, but let your heart keep my commandments. For length of days and years of life and abundant welfare they will give you. Do not let loyalty and faithfulness forsake you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart. For you will find favor and good repute in the sight of the Lord and of people. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. And do not rely on your own insight. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will make straight your path. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and turn away from evil. It will be a healing for your flesh and a refreshment for your body. Honor the Lord with your substance and with the fruits of your first produce. Then your barns will be filled with plenty. Your vats will be bursting with wine. My child, do not despise the Lord's discipline or be weary of his reproof. For the Lord reproves one he loves, as the Father, the Son, who he delights. Our second reading is from 2 Corinthians, chapter 8, verses 7 through 15. Since you excel in so many ways in your faith, your gifted speakers, your knowledge, your enthusiasm, and your love from us, I want you to excel also in the gracious acts of giving. I am not commanding you to do this, but I am testing how genuine your love is by comparing it with the eagerness of other churches. You know the generous grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. Through he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor, so by his poverty he could make you rich. Here is my advice. It would be good for you to finish what you started a year ago. Last year, you were first who wanted to give, and you were the first to begin doing it. Now you should finish what you started. Let the eagerness you showed in the beginning be matched now by your giving. Give in proportion to what you have. Whatever you give is acceptable if you give it eagerly. And give accordingly to what you have, not what you don't have. Of course, I don't mean your giving should make life easy for others and hard for yourselves. I only mean that there should be some equality. Right now, you have plenty and can help those who are in need. Later, they will have plenty and can share with you when you need it. In this way, things will be equal. As the scriptures say, those who gathered a lot had nothing over. And those who gathered only had. Those who gathered a little had enough. Here ends today's reading.
Thank you.
about excellence in giving. Excellence in giving. And so my purpose on this Sunday
value of this stewardship moment is because of you, the church changes lives. Now let me tell you, you, the members of St. John's United Church of Christ in Orwigsburg, have certainly changed my life. I first came to this church as a young bride, married less than a year. I was working at the Anthracite Research Center in Schuylkill Haven, where Anytime Fitness and Miller Brothers are located now. It was a federal facility looking into alternative uses for anthracite research. I worked on two projects, one using hard coal as a medium for gas chromatography, that is, separating a mixed gas into its components. And another project was analyzing acid mine water and figuring out how to neutralize it. In other words, I was a nerd, an introvert, and someone with low self-confidence. When Bob and I first attended church here, members of St. John's encouraged us to join the choir. In fact, Isabel Rhodes was one of the first to ask us to join. Within the choir, I found new friends who enjoy music just as much as I do. There was an adult Sunday school class which challenged me to find ways to express my faith in everyday situations. I was given the opportunity to teach Sunday school, 5th and 6th grade, and to teach Vacation Bible School. There were Bible study classes and other classes that encouraged me to learn about my faith and examine it. All of these experiences stimulated my spiritual growth and changed my life. Above all, the biggest difference in my life came when I had the opportunity to substitute as organist. Of course, I was not very good at first. Since I had learned to play a spin organ, which has one octave of pedals, that was long. Have you looked at our church organ? The pedals on there are 2.5 octaves of pedals, and they're this long. You have to play with both feet, and I only played with my left foot on my spinning organ. As I said, I was not very good at first, but I persisted. The members of this congregation were very kind. They complimented me when I played okay, and they didn't criticize me too much when I made mistakes. They kept encouraging me, and I kept practicing. Now I can play with both feet, and I did get better playing the organ. I don't play as well as Prima, but I did get better. Now I feel I can play adequately for Sunday morning worship, a funeral, or a wedding. I would like to thank you for giving me the confidence to do that. Okay, that's enough about me. Now I want to talk a little bit about the church. In the past few months, I've frequently mentioned to Bob that I think all of us here at St. John's take for granted that this church will always be here. Ladies and gentlemen, we need to make sure that is the case, that this church is here for our children and grandchildren. Through the investment of our time, our talent, our influence, and of course, our income. I think many of us already have a lot of time and talent invested here. But I would like you to think about using your influence to get others to come to St. John's United Church of Christ. Tell your friends, your relatives, your neighbors, about our really great minister, our good music, our loving congregation, and the joy and hope that we share as we worship Jesus and God here. Invite them to Bible study. We need to share our faith with others so we can make a difference in their lives. And finally, we need your income. Even if you are not attending Sunday services, if you watch the service on Facebook or YouTube, there's the cost of the internet provider and the cost of the electricity required to run the computer and the equipment that broadcasts it. Our dedicated pastor needs to be paid, as well as our secretary and the director of music. Our beautiful church here and our organ need to be maintained. And just as the cost of living has increased for us as individuals and families, so has the cost of keeping St. John's running. Remember, whether you are here or not, the costs continue. I urge you to consider how you can increase your support for St. John's United Church of Christ. Don't take for granted that this church will always be here. Please continue to give of your time, your talent, your influence, and of course, your income, to make sure that we can continue to change lives. Because of you, St. John's United Church of Christ in Orwigsburg, Pennsylvania, changes lives. You have certainly changed my life. I hope that this church and its congregation has changed your life as well.
Thank you.
seizure that he had. They're awaiting a meeting with the neurologist to talk about treatment and what it is that they're dealing with him. But and he is stable this morning. So, Jen contacted us and said, please pray, please pray. So, when I say there are people depending on those prayers, I had that in mind, but of course, that there are many others as well. So we will offer our prayers for Arlo today for his health and well-being. And several others that I will mention here this morning. We are praying for Deb Goodale, who will be having knee surgery on Tuesday, on the 14th. That would be this coming Tuesday. Deb Goodale, we pray for successful surgery for her. Edna Hart, whose surgery was postponed, is now going to happen the 2nd of January, January 2nd. Edna Hart, for her knee surgery. We are continuing to offer prayers for Linda Hamilton, who is in the recovery process with Guillain-Barré syndrome. She is still hospitalized at Reading, but getting physical therapy, regular physical therapy for this. And so please continue to offer your prayers for her, her husband, Wayne, as well. Our secretary, Kathy Fago, is asking prayers for her husband, Joe, who will be having surgery this coming week on the 16th, a little later this coming week. Joe Fago. Prayers requested by Ruthann and Mo Moyer for granddaughter Michaela, who is recovering from mono. We pray for her recovery. Isabel Rhodes has prayers for niece Harry and husband Michael Jeremy. We're offering prayers for them. Praying for Mark Miller, who has a broken elbow and is a recovery mode from that, that we pray for Mark as well in the coming days. Are there any others this morning that any would like to share for our need? Yes, the microphone is coming.
Some of you may remember that my husband Don had Guillain-Barré syndrome. It's a neurological disorder that attacks any part of the body. And my husband, unfortunately, was misdiagnosed for 4 weeks until. But what they do is, he was at the High Valley, they do the plasmapheresis, which means they take the blood out of the body, remove the bad antibodies. So he had 5 treatments of those, came home, was doing well, then had a relapse, went back in again, had 5 more. So after that, it was, he had extreme physical therapy because he could not have feeling in his fingers and his face. The walking became very difficult. So he was in intensive physical therapy, and eventually it affected his heart, and he went into cardiac arrest. So that was 2006. And he died in 2013. So I just wanted to help you understand what Guillain-Barré is all about. It's not a very good thing, but I just wanted you, having experienced that, to let you know what Linda is going through at this time.
Yeah, thank you for meditating. Yeah, Linda's getting those blood treatments that you mentioned right now also.
Yeah. After he had 10, they said no more. And he was on 90 milligrams of prednisone for quite a while.
Anyone else who's going to God with our prayers this day? We know you hear our prayers, and we're thankful for that. We know you are with our friends, church family, loved ones. presence, an encouraging presence, a healing presence. So we pray for everyone mentioned this morning, and many others as well. And we pray for Arlo in particular, his health and well-being being treated today in the hospital for his health and for the days to come. May your spirit already be working in him and assisting doctors and all who would be involved in this and with his family. The fact that you love us makes such a difference. It translates into hope and healing and encouragement. We thank you for that. Our prayers to this world, for which there is much turmoil within, in many places, sometimes far away, many that we hear on the news, many that we are concerned about, deeply concerned. We pray for peace. We pray for understanding. We pray for the furtherance of the mission of Christ in this world and for our own personal witness to that truth. In Christ's name, we pray the prayer he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now I'll ask you to please stand for our closing.
Amen.
wrong with you?
Well,
but